Subscribe to Drama YT and press the bell icon to get the latest videos first of the all. Hey guys, how are you? It's K2 and welcome back to Drama YT. Have you watched the C-drama Skate Into Love? If not, let me tell you, this was one of the best sport-themed romance drama with a fluffy comedy. I have always been a fan of rom-coms, and if you are not, I am going to make you one. As in this video, I am counting down my top 10 sporty Chinese dramas of all time. Believe me, you are gonna love the sports genre in the Chinese dramas. As always, check the description box for more information and do comment below that which C-drama list you want to watch next. Now give this video a like and let's get to it. Number 10, Crossfire. In 2008, Xiaofeng is a downcast esports team leader who is barely keeping his team together. Esports is in its infancy and there is little money to be earned. Xiaofeng's team is looked down upon and ridiculed, yet they insist on fighting for their dreams. In 2019, Lu Xiaobo is a genius in the same game, a masterful player. In reality, he is a disabled young man in a wheelchair. He vowed to continue his brother's legacy to become a professional esports player, yet loses his chance to join a professional team. Despite living 11 years apart, a cosmic glitch allowed the two to transcend space and time as they chance upon each other within the same game. From a position of mutual distrust to that of a camaraderie, they form their own teams and help each other grow in life and as players to achieve their dreams. Number 9. The Prince of Tennis. Lucia is a tennis prodigy who lived overseas since he was a child with his parents. He has inherited his father's outstanding strength and tennis talent. However, trapped under the shadow of his father, Lucia only sees tennis as a tool to win over him, losing the passion and happiness in playing tennis altogether. Upon returning to China, he joins in a high school tennis team and met various tennis masters. Here he begins to realize the meaning of tennis and figure out his own identity as a player. In the process of working to win the National League, Lucia and his teammates learn to work as a group and understand the importance of friends. Number 8. The Whirlwind Girl. 10 years ago, in the town of Anyang, the origin of Yuan Wudao martial arts, world champion Xu Xiangnan was accused of doping and then his prestigious title was stripped. He became a disgrace to the town and tarnished their name in the arts of Yuan Wudao. The story of Tornado Girl is set in the present and revolves around his adopted daughter and his student Qi Bai Shao. In her journey of becoming a true Yuan Wudao martial artist, fighting her way to the top and reclaiming her teacher's innocence. Along the way, she encounters friends such as her stoic and selfless Yuan Wudao senior Ruo Bai, the warm and caring but mysteriously secluded medic Yu Chu Wan, and the flirtatious, playful Fang Ting Hao with a hidden agenda. Together they learn, grow, compete, find love and fight for their dreams. Number 7. The Best of You in My Mind. Lin Shichi is a college student majoring in veterinary medicine. She is well liked and known for being bright and cheerful. Although on the inside, she is more insecure than she would like to let on. Also attending the same university is her childhood friend, avid archer and national defense student Xu Fang. He has had a crush on Lin Shichi since they were both at school, but has never plucked up enough courage to let her know. Although he can be quick-tempered with others, he always treats Lin Shichi with great tenderness. When she loses a bet connected to an arm wrestling bout, Lin Shichi has to forfeit a month's living costs, a twist of fate that brings the two ex-school friends closer together than ever. And one evening, their friendship is turned upside down when Shichi gets drunk and long suppressed emotions suddenly come to the shore. Number 6. Sweet Combat. As the eldest daughter of the Fang conglomerate, Fang Yu was raised to become the sole successor of the company. Yet, she goes against her family's objections to pursue boxing and won the championship title at the young age of 18. On the other hand, Ming Tian comes from a very poor family. he once stopped schooling for 3 years in order to work, and then he decided to apply for his sports scholarship despite not having any background whatsoever. Fang Yu was one of the first to see his talents, and their relationship grows over time. Number 5. My Mr. Mermaid. A young swimmer tries to stage a comeback 3 years after a scandal. Tangi Bai is a former champion swimmer who was wrongfully accused of doping that derailed his competitive career 4 years ago. He returns after a 4-year hiatus to compete for the South Physical Education College alongside his best friend Shi Ruifeng against their biggest rival Hengo Yang of North Physical Education College. At the competition, Ibai meets rookie sports reporter Yundo, who is assigned to cover the competition but has a fear of water due to a near drowning incident in her past. Yundo also happens to rent a room in Ibai's family home, and the two become good friends. Can Yundo encourage Ibai to prove his innocence in his past scandal and regain his swimming glory? Number 4. My Unicorn Girl. Sang Tian is an aspiring figure skater. On the day she turns 18, she vows to her family that she will be accepted to the same university that her mother once attended. To get in, she must pass a test, which she, an exceptionally competent skater and a student, expects to ace. However, things do not go according to the plan for Sang Tian, and she fails the exam. Undaunted, Sang Tian decides not to give up, and in desperation, she dresses as a male ice hockey player and joins in a trial match for the college team. She unexpectedly signs and is selected as a part of the men's ice hockey program. Things get even more complicated for her when she realizes that Wang Bin, a young man she has crossed swords with in the past, is also a part of the team. Worse still, she finds she must share a dormitory with him and struggles to keep her true identity a secret. On the ice, Sang Tian and Wang Bin prove to be the catalysts for their team's newfound success, and the team finds itself with a shot at the championship. As the two students start to get to know one another, they develop a mutual respect for one another, but could that one day turn to love? Number 3. Gang Your Heart. Their meeting was a recipe for disaster, but their romance is sweet. This is a love story between an esports gamer and a Tsundere live streamer. Ji Xiang Kong had the reputation, the good looks, and the hordes of fangirls. Xu Ying meets him during an international competition and jumps at the chance to boost her own popularity, oblivious to the fact that his reputation in the world of esports is strangely tarnished. Instead of helping her, the association hurt her even more. The experience turns out to be a blessing in disguise as Xu Ying finds her calling. By chance, she discovers that Ji Xia Kong is actually a misunderstood genius. Number 2. Skate Into Love. A short track speed skating girl crosses paths with the ice hockey god of their school. Despite starting off on the wrong foot, they start on a journey to chase after their dreams. During elementary school, the timid and cowardly Liu Bing had to endure his seatmate Tang Xiu's constant bullying. Even so, they share one thing in common, a dream on the ice. When they meet again at Linda University, Liu Bing has already become the school's ice god, while Tang Xiu's future remains hazy. Liu Bing pulls a few strings to turn Tang Xiu into his helper with the goal of getting payback for everything that she did. The more they spend time together, the more Liu Bing notices Tang Xiu's good qualities. He realizes that his courage on ice is inspired by Tang Xiu herself. In turn, he helps Tang Xiu rediscover her dream in speed skating. Problems arise when misunderstandings from the past catch up to them. Figure skating prodigy Yu Yan enters the picture. Tang Xiu's first love, Bai Sheng, also returns while school beauty Zhao Ran continues to make trouble. As they face roadblocks from the disapproving parents and fierce competitors, they land in the crossroad that will decide their sports career. As the two impassioned youths put on their skates, they glide into the unknown but exciting future ahead. Hikaru No Go. On a hunt for treasure and extra cash, 6th year primary school student Si Guang discovered an old go board in his grandfather's house. Upon touching the go board, he was possessed by the spirit of a go master from the Southern Dynasty during the reign of Emperor Song named Chu Ying that resides within. Chu Ying dedicated his life to the game of Go, and under his influence, Si Guang gradually developed a passion for the game. Ping Pong Life. Endless competitions take place on the ping pong tables with two young men at the center. Su Tan is physically weak but strongly passionate, and Yu Kenan, who is unruly but highly talented.
Despite their opposite personalities, Sudan and Yukenans mirror the same journey in their sports career and witness a pivotal time in the history of Chinese ping pong. Sudan is a player who undergoes a major transformation under the influence of his grandfather. He starts the sport to improve his health and gets noticed for his abilities. Yukenan is a star player from a famous family who comes to realize that there are so many things that he has yet to learn. For their dreams and for the sake of their country, they stand at two ends during the biggest competitions of their lives.
Number 1. The King's Avatar. In the multiplayer online game Glory, Yeshu is well known as a textbook level expert and top tier player Yeshu. Due to a series of circumstances, he was forcefully expelled out of his professional team. After leaving the pro gaming scene, he resides at an internet cafe employed as one of the managers. When Glory launches their 10th server, he throws himself into the game once more. Equipped with 10 years of gaming experience, memories of the past, and an incomplete self-made weapon, his journey back to the top begins. So that was it guys, the video ends here. I hope you have liked this video. If you have watched the video till here, give this video a like and subscribe to DramaYT. And yet you guys have not followed me on the Instagram handle, which is right in front of you. It is called dramayt.k2. Follow me there as well. And I will see you later. As always, your K2. Love, peace and hugs. It's been a pleasure.